Almighty, please shower your bountiful blessings to all the people of the world. Please bless us so that people suffering from COVID-19 get well soon. May your blessings act as a boon to all the people who have lost their belongings as well as their houses in the dangerous super cyclone Amphan. Now the nature's green is so empty as all the trees fell down. Please bless us so that we can join our hands together and get back the lost green color. Please do bless us so that we can work hand in hand to maintain the purity of nature as well as protect the pure green color of nature forever, generation after generation. Amen.
Nature's beauty is so enlightening. It captivates the attention. It's so mesmerizing. The vivid oceans and the sky, it looks so good and high. The beautiful scenic view, everything seems awesome and new. Everything is as beautiful as dew. The beauty of sunset tells us something each day, that another day has ended today. The beauty of sunrise tells us this day is here to stay. The wind blowing on the face tells us life is a running race. So get inspired by nature each day to make your way. The beautiful flowers of red, yellow and blue, the sparkling grass with the morning dew, the birds singing up in the trees as a gentle wind blows the morning leaves, beautiful butterflies going their way, the beauty of nature really makes our day.
COVID-19, the most frustrating disease nowadays. It can also be called a trending virus, and the topic is trending too. So, this virus has caused a lot of damage to human life, economy of nation. But if we see it from a different side, then we can see that although it caused a lot of damage, but has also helped the ecosystem a lot. Due to lockdown and decline of plant travel has caused many regions drop in air pollution. The China lockdown measure resulted in a 25% reduction in carbon emission and 50% reduction in nitrogen oxide emission. I can see arguments in both directions, says Nicholas. It may be the case that people who are avoiding travel right now are really appreciating spending time with families and focusing on those really core priorities. These moments of crisis can highlight how important those priorities are and help people focus on the health and well-being of family and friends and also community. If this change in focus as a result of the pandemic sticks, then this could help to keep emissions lower, Nicholas suggests. But there's another way it could go. It could also be that people are putting off long-distance trips but plan on taking them later, Nicholas says. Frequent flying forms a large part of the carbon footprint for the people who do it regularly. So these emissions could simply come back if people return to their old habits. With COVID-19 spreading rapidly in the state, the last thing that West Bengal needed was a super cyclone, wreaking havoc in the coastal districts and the state capital Kolkata. The super cyclone Amphan, the biggest natural calamity to ever hit the state, tore through several districts on May 20, leaving a trail of death and enormous destruction originating in the Bay of Bengal. Amphan crashed upon the coastal belt of the state near Sagar Island, at a speed of 155 to 165 km per hour, with gust wind speed going up to 185 km per hour, along with very heavy rain, and proceeded on a trail of devastation through Kolkata on its journey into Bangladesh. As of May 22, at least 86 people were killed, lakhs of homesteads broken, thousands of trees uprooted, infrastructure damaged, agricultural land and crops destroyed, ruining the lives of lakhs of people who were already in the face of a major financial crisis due to the nationwide lockdown. According to preliminary estimates, around 10.5 lakh houses have been destroyed and more than 1.36 crore people have been badly hit. Overall, around 60% of the people in the state have been affected by the super cyclone. Severe cyclonic storm Nisarga is a currently active tropical cyclone headed towards the coastline of Indian state of Maharashtra and Gujarat. Nisarga started as a deep depression in the Arabian Sea and was expected to hit the western coastline of India. On 2nd June 2020, the Indian Meteorological Department revisited Nisarga as severe cyclonic form while confirming its landfall near the coastal town of Alibaug in Maharashtra on 3rd June 2020. The cyclonic storm is the second tropical cyclone of the year 2020 North Indian Ocean cyclone, seasoned to hit the Indian subcontinent in a span of 2 weeks. After Cyclone Amphan, the first super cyclonic storm to occur in the Bay of Bengal in the 21st century. Nisarga is the first severe cyclonic storm since 1891 to impact Mumbai, one of the most popular cities in
शहरों में रौनक आएगी, फिर से गांवों में लौटेगी हंसी, फिर से साथ सारे यार होंगे, ना होगी पाबंदी, ही कोई फिर से सड़कों पे सब नाचेंगे, पटरी पे पहिए भागेंगे, गूंजेंगे खेलों के मैदान, बांटेंगे हम खुशियां, गम भी हम मिलकर बांटेंगे, फिर से होगी सपनों की उड़ान, जो साथ दे दे सारा साथ दे सारा इंडिया, फिर मुस्कुराएगा इंडिया, जो साथ दे सारा।